Well, good morning. It's a joy to welcome you to worship. And if you're glad to be here, say a big amen this morning.
Amen.
Now, I want you to hold your fingers up just like this. You know what we're going to do. Turn it around and just put a big smile on your face. You look so nice with that big smile. And if you're visiting today, a special welcome to you. And take a moment, fill out the Connect card in the pew rack in front of you. And we are happy to have you here. Let's welcome all of our guests this morning. I want to send birthday greetings to Harvey Burris, who is at home and will be watching on television. His 92nd birthday on the 22nd of this month. Let's give Harvey a big happy birthday. As you know, this is my favorite Sunday of the year, and I am so excited today to have with us our young people from the Baptist Children's Homes and their house parents, and especially Dr. Michael Blackwell, who's come to speak to our hearts and to lead us in worship. And I'm going to ask Bobby Boyd, one of our own, to come and introduce Dr. Blackwell. Bobby served on the Board of Trustees and actually was chair of the Board of Trustees of the Baptist Children's Homes. So I'd like for him to do the honors of introducing Dr. Blackwell to us. Bobby?
Thank you. Now, I'm pleased, honored to be able to introduce Michael, because I'm always pleased to introduce my elders. Now we have a little thing going here about who's the oldest. But I am honored to be able to introduce him. I've known him for a number of years. I'm not so sure how long. I don't know, maybe 25 or more. And I've known him from a couple of walks of life, and have grown to appreciate very much his calling to this ministry and his passion and enthusiasm with which he goes about his task. Michael comes with a rich background, having obtained his undergraduate degree from the University of North Carolina. And a couple of master's degrees from Wake Forest and a doctoral degree in ministry. He has been active as a minister in a number of churches. He has also had experience in radio. And for the last 28 years, has very capably led the ministry, our ministry, of Baptist Children's Homes of North Carolina. Michael is also a writer. He has authored about five or so books, and you might want to take a look at those if you haven't already. There's some good reading. They're all about things like miracles at Baptist Children's Homes, etc. So it is really an honor, and we are very fortunate here at Woodlawn, quite honestly, to be able to have Michael or Brenda Gray, one or the other, come in most every year at Thanksgiving. We're really, really deeply appreciative for that. And you're going to be in for quite a treat today. So won't you join me in welcoming Michael Blackwell.
Well, good morning. Good morning, Woodlawners. It's good to be with you today. What a wonderful crowd that we're having today. And this is also my favorite Sunday of the year, too, Brother Ed. I'm delighted to be here. It has been a couple of years now. I want to express my appreciation to you at Woodlawn for your continued support and encouragement, your prayers, and your financial gifts to us. They mean so very, very much to us. Now, I do want to say dual thanks. First of all, I want to thank Bobby for his good introduction for me, to me, and to thank him for his faithful service as a trustee. He's only one of two men who served two consecutive years as chair of our board, and he's currently the chair of our Programs and Services Committee, thus serving on the executive committee of our board. Also, he is one of those who helped me begin a new ministry to the aging called the North Carolina Baptist Aging Ministry, or NCBAM. Not only did Bobby become a part of the original task force, he helped us with a lot of contacts across North Carolina and has now introduced this exciting program to Woodlawn Church. And he and Brother Ed are going to be a part of a new video that we have shot and are currently editing. At the recent Baptist State Convention, your own Carol Morrison stood and talked about the Oasis Care Team, which reaches some of the aging adults here in this area of Catawba County. So I appreciate Carol and I appreciate Bobby for what they've done for NC BAM. And I appreciate what Ed has done as pastor to encourage us and be a part of this. I also want to thank Ed for his outstanding service the last 2 years as president of the Baptist State Convention of North Carolina. At the same time, I need to thank you for allowing him the freedom to do that, to serve not only on the executive committee, but as the leader of our convention, as one to whom we could look to for inspiration and encouragement. And the man can preach too. He preached an outstanding convention sermon this year as he did last year. Dr. Young, I thank you for that service that you gave to us. You set the bar high for anybody who's going to come after you. You are a dedicated Christian person. I got an email this morning from someone who knew I was going to be here, a fellow pastor and fellow member of the executive committee of the general board of directors of the convention, talking about Ed and his outstanding service, his humility, and his dedication as a servant of God. God bless you. On November the 11th, the Baptist Children's Home celebrated its 126th birthday. Last year, 2010, was an outstanding year. We had our quasquicentennial, a year-long celebration of our 125th anniversary. God has allowed me to be here for 28 and a half years, so that means that I was here for our centennial in 1985. Now, to be here for the sesquicentennial, that means that Bobby Boyd and I would both be 93 years of age. The sesquicentennial is the 150th anniversary. Now, I want to strike a deal with you right now. I am 6 months older than you are. You will be 69 on the last day of this year. I was 69 on May the 3rd. If you will be here for the 150th anniversary, I will be here. And we will go ahead and commit right now in the year 2035 for you to introduce me at Woodlawn Baptist Church. Is that a deal? All right, that's a deal. You heard that, ladies and gentlemen. Each year we have a video which seeks to capture the essence, the heart of who we are at BCH. This year, we are revolving that video around the theme of changed. Changed lives. Your life can change no matter what age or station you may be. And Corey is an example of a changed life. She is the one who is featured in the video. But not only that, you will see her in a moment in the video. Corey is also here with us today, live and in person, and she's going to come and kind of supplement a little bit of the video a little later in our worship service today. So I want you to just be open to the Spirit of God in this service today, that God's Spirit can touch you where you need to be touched. If you need to be changed way down deep in your soul and your spirit, you're hanging on to something that you don't need to be hanging on to anymore, then let it go. Be changed. If you're reaching for something in life, then just hang on to the Lord Jesus Christ. You too can be changed. So we open our hearts, our minds, and our spirits to being changed.
I'm Corey Nicole Clay, and I grew up in Mandeville, Louisiana. When I go outside, What I like to do most is play football or basketball or just hit the volleyball or something that has movement with it. Sometimes I just run. I love running. I can't even remember most of the things I used to do before I came and got saved. It's just so wonderful.
You know, all of us have storms in our lives. Well, they had literally had a storm in their life, and Hurricane Katrina had just destroyed their home there. And so they uprooted and came here to Madison County. And the family was having storms and turmoil, and they needed help. And Stephen, Corey's dad, came to Baptist Children's Homes to get that help that they needed.
You know, it was bad. I mean, it was real bad. I just went to my knees and asked the good Lord to lead me somewhere where my children can get the help that they need. And they let us here.
When I first came here, it was kind of a long night because getting used to a new bed and new people and new place to live, it's hard on everybody.
She had a hard time at first adjusting here. Every day was a bit of a struggle. She wanted to do well, but just did not have it within her to do that at that time.
She was belligerent at the time and sometimes disrespectful. She had issues she was dealing with, and she had a lot of turmoil in her life.
It's just a good place for a child to come into a good, structured Christian environment and learn. And the parents can learn too.
If I wasn't here at Broyhill or without any of these people in my life, I wouldn't be the same person. I just wouldn't be me. This is a new Corey, and it's because of these house parents helping me and everything.
She had really bonded with us, I think, as a family, because we have in our cottage, our house parent teams work 2 weeks on duty and 2 weeks off duty. And the 2 weeks that Bill and I are not on duty, my mother and father are the house parents that would work with us.
They were grandma and grandpa figure, and we got a mother and father figure in our daughter and son-in-law that work here too. And the kids like that. And they kid us about it, you know, but we just have a good time.
And so we had a true family environment, and Corey just really needed that family environment, and she just really blossomed with us in that setting.
That November, on November 20th, me and my best friend Shauna got saved. And it was while we were in youth group, we were talking about Revelations on how everybody sins. We need to confess of them and ask God for forgiveness. And it had touched my heart because of how I've acted and everything. And the majority of my cottage got saved that night, which was like the best thing ever. And then I got baptized on May 2nd.
After she had her salvation experience, she changed immensely, her attitude, her desires. She's one of the most loving children I've ever come across. Corey would put anybody before herself in a way that most teenagers don't. Most teenagers care about what they're wearing, how their hair is fixed, if they have the latest gadgets and cell phones and all this. She doesn't have those things, and she doesn't care. She doesn't ask about them. She doesn't mention them. She's not a worldly kind of person.
Most people think I'm weird because I don't care about what other people think. All I care about is what Jesus thinks. And that's just the way that I live. The Lord means everything. He's what keeps me going every day. And knowing that He's by my side every day, just, it makes me happy. And I wouldn't be able to do anything without Him.
She has a look about her that she's just, life is good for her. And she's happy because she loves the Lord. And she shares that with everybody. She just wants everybody to know, you know, that the Lord has made such a difference in her life. And she's new, and that's what we're supposed to be when that happens to us. And just thank goodness for Baptist Children's Homes, where she had a place to be taken care of and loved, unconditional love. We give these children unconditional love. Doesn't matter what they've done. And she's safe here, and she's just a new girl. She's a new person.
The most rewarding thing for me is that I feel like I do get to carry out the Great Commission while I work here. It's not the programs or the procedures or anything that, we just get to share the gospel and we get to live that and fulfill the Great Commission that way.
And the flower, it just reminds her of when I used to always bring her flowers every day.
Uh-huh.
And the heart means we love each other unconditionally.
We're here to make sure that these children know about Jesus and his love. And that's what we do every day. We show them that love and we teach them that love. And when they come to that decision and make that decision for themselves, it's wonderful for us because that's why we're here.
The changes that have happened, I have a better bond with my dad. My bond's getting stronger with my biological mom. My stepmom, she's practically my real mom. And she's still there. And I love her.
Since she's been here and she's gotten saved and we've all learned how to deal with things that come up, her and I's relationship has definitely gotten stronger. The bond is a lot stronger with her and I now. She's definitely changed. She's matured beyond what I thought would happen.
And I love these people to death. They're not my friends, they're my second family. Because we've been down, they know I've been through a lot of hard roads and knocks, and they've helped me through it.
That's the message that I would want to get out to everybody, is it's not just about, you know, these kids that are that have behavior issues or whatever. It really is about healing families and introducing them to Christ.
What I would like to say to NC Baptist is Baptist Children's Homes wouldn't be the same without them. And if we didn't have their help, Baptist Children's Homes wouldn't be here. And there wouldn't be so many kids getting help that they need. It's a great place, and I love it here.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was once lost, but now I'm found. Was
another young man who has experienced change in his life is my friend Kamani. Kamani has been with me all across the state this Thanksgiving season, as has Corey and a number of those who are here today. He has a wonderful testimony to share. First of all, Kamani, I want to thank you for your faithfulness in sharing your testimony. Last year, he shared before several thousand people at the Baptist State Convention of North Carolina during our 125th anniversary presentation some of the things that has happened to him in his life, and his life is still changing. He is still literally and spiritually growing. Kamani?
My name is Kamani. I'm 16 years old. When I first came to Broil Hill 4 years ago, I weighed 32 pounds, more size 3 toddler clothes. At home, my bedroom was a closet, and I was fed when my mom and dad told me I deserved it sometimes. And sometimes when I was fed, Mom would tell me that there would be poison in my food. So being a hungry child, it's hard to decide to go to bed hungry or eat something with poison in it. I was very low in fiber before I came. Went to Charlotte very once in a while to get blood draws. And finally, 3 years ago, they decided to put me on growth hormone. And I have grown tremendously and spiritually. I'd never been to school before, and I came to Broyhill. I started in the sixth grade. I started out making D's and C's, and now I'm in the 10th grade. I'm making almost A honor roll. My behavior has changed a lot. I do not stay in trouble. I'm rarely in trouble now. I have Jesus in my heart, which is great. I do not have to worry about when I'm going to eat again, and I have a nice bed with sheets, and it's something I can cover up with at night. And I'd like to thank y'all for everything y'all do to support the Baptist Children Home. Y'all are helping many kids like me. Thank you.
Just as Kamani has his story, just as Ted Chandler has his story, just as Corey has her story, all of these young people who are here today have a story. And let's face it, their story does involve separation and trauma. If you can, in your life, imagine those basic foundational connections, belonging, love, appreciation, acceptance, being severed, then you may have some idea what it is like for some of the young people to come into our care. But when they come into our care, as you have seen already, as Ted so well put it, this works. And it works because of the faithfulness of people like you, our North Carolina Baptist friends and neighbors at churches like Woodlawn and beyond. It works because the power of the Holy Spirit still rests on this ministry. It works because we are doing God's work. As I mentioned earlier, I am doubly pleased today that we can not only show the video in which Corey is featured, but that we've got Corey here in person today. At the earlier service, I expressed my appreciation to her for traveling many, many, many hundreds, if not thousands of miles during this Thanksgiving season with our staff. And each time I hear her, she is a blessing to me. I was actually overcome during the earlier service today. And in her usual, inimitable, helpful Christian way, she just reached up and gave me a hug right in front of God and everybody. And that helped me get myself back together. But you have been a blessing to us, Corey. If you'll come up here now. And again, I want to express my thanks to you. I truly believe with this personality that you have, never meeting a stranger, blessing the Baptist State Convention as you did last week, God has his hands on you. God is going to bless you. You are a changed life. And if there was ever anything as close to what we call a Damascus Road experience, this young lady had that. It's a pleasure and a joy for me to introduce to you Corey Nicole Clay.
Hello, I'm Corey, and I'm 16 years old in 11th grade. I go to Pisgah High School, and I am actively involved in the NJROTC program. Around 19 months old, my mom has started neglecting me and my sisters. She was doing drugs and getting drunk right in front of us, or she would send us outside unsupervised while she did these things with her friends. She was having other affairs with men while still married to my father. She has allowed her boyfriends to be inappropriate with my sisters while under the influence. I've been told that I've been molested too, but because I was so young, I have no memories of this. My father had found out what was going on. He had my mom charged with neglect and abuse. Her parental rights were terminated, and he was given full custody of all four of us girls. He had remarried and moved up to Madison County, North Carolina, with two of my sisters and my stepmother. I stayed behind my grandmother, but became very rebellious and disrespectful to her and the other adults in my life. I was continuously getting in trouble in school and was almost expelled numerous times. That is when she decided to send me to live with my dad in North Carolina. I was still spiraling out of control, and my dad put me in Broyhill home in Clyde. I was a very angry child and didn't know what to do. I was confused at first, but then on November 20th, 2009 is when I really changed and turned around and looked at what I had. I was saved during a youth fellowship at Woodland Baptist Church. It was also then that my house parents took me to seek the medical attention that I had needed for a very serious health issue that led to a very low self-esteem. In combination with my salvation, my improving health, and ongoing counseling for me and my family, I have become closer to the house parents, my family, but even more, day by day, I'm becoming closer to God. And it's because of all of you. I have a favorite memory verse, and it is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I would also like to thank all of you for everything you've done for me, my family, and the other kids in care. It is because of you that Baptist Children's Home still exists. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Corey. She mentioned, and you saw on the video, Bill and Alicia Wilkerson, who are two of her house parents. They are here today, and we're going to hear from some of them in a moment, but I want to express my appreciation for Bill and Alicia hanging in there, for doing what they can. Bill is absolutely one of the most talented people I've ever met as far as carving things are concerned, and I have several of his carvings in my office, and if there is a better cookie maker on the face of the planet than Alicia, I don't know who it is. Now, did you bring me any cookies today? I take it all back. I want you to recognize Bill and Alicia. Let's give them a hand for what they have done for Corey and all the Coreys that come our way. Stand up a minute. Now, Alicia, I want you to come up along with Richard and Dathan, and they're going to say a couple of words, and I think it would be well if they actually introduced these young men and young women who are here today as a part of our service. These are the men and the women who really make things hum at Baptist Children's Homes, and I'm delighted to be able to introduce them. So,
I knit too, Dr. Blackwell. I brought some scarves today. I'll show you, but
All right.
A little frilly. You might not like those. Bill and I have been with Baptist Children's Homes for 13 years now, and for the first 12 and a half of those years, we did work at Blanton Cottage with my parents, Bob and Lou Arnsdorf, who you saw in the video. A year ago this week, my father had a tear in his aorta and was very seriously ill. He was in a coma for 5 weeks. And in January, after he recovered and went through some rehab, he's home and doing well now, but he's medically retired. And so Bill and I moved around the loop, and we work now at Wall Cottage with Rick and Jenny McAllister. And after 12 and a half years of working primarily with teenage girls, we now have a mix, because Wall Cottage is a sibling cottage. And so we have little boys for the first time. It's kind of interesting. I have two sibling groups. Yeah, from teenage girls to Levi's five. Well, he was five. He's now six. But Levi, you want to come up first since you're the youngest? His shirt was tucked in when we got in the van at 6 o'clock this morning. Yeah. I've worked for Baptist Children's Homes, like I said, for 13 years. And Levi, we've probably had close to 200 children in our care. He's the first one I ever broke. I shut his finger in a door this week. You want to show him your finger? have his sister Cheyenne, who is 7, and sister Savannah, who is 12. She just had her birthday this week. And then we also have siblings Christian and Rosa.
They can't see you right there.
They can't see you. You want to move over there? Christian is 10 and Rosa is 8. And I have Tabitha, who's 15. Caitlin, who's 16. Another Cheyenne. That only gets a little bit confusing. She loves her nickname, though.
Gassy.
It's nothing personal. Her last name just starts with that. And she's 12. And Michelle, who was in the video, you saw her at the end casting that fishing pole. She's 11. And Corey. And this is Wall Cottage.
Bill, I'm jealous. You got boys. My name is Richard Schwall. My wife and I, Diane, have been Baptist Children's Homes for 13 years also. We have a cottage full of young ladies, and it's called Haywood Cottage. Our new mission statement is sharing hope and changing lives. And ladies and gentlemen, we can't do that without Jesus Christ and without your love and your prayers and your support. I want you to know that Baptist Children's Home is just not that campus in Thomasville or in Clyde, but we're here for your community. If you know of any family that's in dire straits, we hear of people living in cars, tough economic times. If there's any family that needs help, please contact us. We're here to help. We're just not for those people, but we're here for your community also. At this time, I'm going to ask our young ladies to come up. We only have one sibling group, but we have three young ladies of it, and I'll introduce them. Miss Montana, Miss Caitlin, and Miss Little Ashley. There she is. This is one group of young ladies that we have. They're all sisters. Miss Mercedes, Miss Katie, Miss Michaela, Miss Anna, Miss Anna, Miss Alex, Miss Big Ashley, and Miss Sierra. And these are the ladies of Haywood Cottage.
And I got the boys. God is good. They're the best. They're in the West. What can I say? I'm Dathan Arant and my wife, Diana. We're from West Tennessee, and we commute 423 miles to work at the best children's home in the world. And God has really blessed us, letting us come to North Carolina and to be a part of your family and to work with the children. I have boys from 10 to 18 years of age, so that's a pretty good spread, but they're a pretty good bunch of boys. Tyler, would you come up front and just stand down here on the front, please? Anthony Paul? Trevor? I have a sibling group also, the brothers Shaquin and Karan, which have been with me for over 7 years. Chris. Trevor also. And Logan, which is Caitlin's brother. And you've met Kamani. When I look into the Bible, one of my favorite chapters of the Bible is the last one, Revelations. And the reason it is because when I look at God's Word and I open it up, and He has revealed to me the one part of the Bible that is revealing to you and I the future. It tells what the future holds. For one that has come to have a relationship with Christ, it gives that glorious future that we're going to be with Him in the place that He has prepared for us. I invite you, look into the future. Look into the eyes of these children. This is the future. You know, our country's in a mess, but they can pull it out with God's help if they just have that relationship with Him. And through your help, these children have beds to sleep in, warm meals to eat, and house parents that love them and share the Word of God with them. These guys right here, I have two purposes that God has sent us to do from Tennessee. One of them is to show them Jesus Christ, and the other is to become fine young Christian men that will someday be fathers. Thank you, North Carolina Baptist. Thank you. You know, we go into Thanksgiving, but I thank you for what you've done, your gifts, your monies, and most of all, your prayers.
Now, as these young women and young men go back, we're going to have our elementary children come up and sing Jesus Loves Me. I just want you to catch the eye of somebody, look at them, covenant to pray for them, hold them up. Just catch the eye of somebody right now. I'm going to miss all of you guys. I've been with you so many times. And when you do Worthy is the Lamb, I always catch your eye every time we do that. This will be the last time that all of us are together for a while. And it gives me an opportunity just to express appreciation to each and every one of you. These folks out here love you dearly. And they're going to have an opportunity in just a moment to give to this ministry to make sure that your future is safe and secure from all alarm. God bless you, children. Thank you very much. You can all be seated except those who are going to be singing Jesus Loves Me. I'm going to let Dr. Young come and kind of make the appeal for this offering. He does it in a way that is different than I would do it because you would expect me to do it. And my friend Ed is going to come and share with you this very important part of our service. Pastor.
Let me read just part of a verse of scripture in James 1, 27. It says, "Pure and undefiled religion before God and the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their trouble." That means that real Christianity is taking care of God's children. Amen? I mean, this is religion pure and undefiled. And every year, you are so generous to give to the Baptist Children's Homes. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for your generosity. And I want to ask you this morning, as we take this offering, do everything. Let's do everything we can, because this is God's work. These are God's children. This is religion, pure and undefiled. It gets no better than this. So let's give from our hearts.
Yes, Jesus loves.
thank everybody at Woodlawn Baptist Church for once again allowing us to come and to be here, to express my appreciation to your good people here for what they do for us, for the encouragement they give, the prayers they offer, the financial support that they so freely are giving to this wonderful ministry. We are just grateful that these boys and girls who are here have a place, a haven of hope and help and healing that they can go to. And it is because of pastors like you and trustees like Bobby and alumni like Ted Chandler and members and friends like you that we're able to do that. And I believe that though we have been around for 126 years, that under God's divine leadership, the best for us is yet to come. God bless you, Ed. Thank you so much.
Now we're going to stand together for our invitation. And this morning, if you would like to give your life to the Lord Jesus, our pastors will be here to receive you. If you would like to make another decision this morning, if you'd like to unite with our church family, you come as we sing.